this video, we will verify pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation technique. So before proceeding to the experiment, let us understand what is PAM modulation and what is PAM demodulation. Basically, pulse amplitude modulation is the process in which the amplitude of the pulse is varied in accordance with the instantaneous amplitude of the message signal at sampling rate. The width and position of the pulse is kept constant. Basically, PAM is a pulse modulation system in which the signal is sampled at regular intervals and each sample is made proportional to the amplitude of the signal at the instant of sampling. There are two types of PAM. One is double polarity PAM, which is self-explanatory. Second is single polarity PAM, in which a fixed DC level is added to the signal to ensure that the pulses are always positive. The ability to use constant amplitude pulses is a major advantage of pulse modulation. And since PAM does not utilize constant amplitude pulses, it is infrequently used. This is the generation of PAM. It utilizes AND gate, pulse shaping network and frequency modulator to generate PAM FM output. This generated output is fed to the demodulator, which consists of a frequency demodulator, a diode detector and a low pass filter. In this way, we can have the original message signal. These are the various waveforms showing continuous signal, that is message signal, pulse amplitude modulated signal and recovered original signal. So let us perform this experiment on the kit. In this kit, we have a pulse amplitude modulator, a pulse amplitude demodulator section. From here, we can have a signal, message signal, whose signal type can be selected with the help of this selector knob. It can be sine wave, square wave, triangular wave, or any arbitrary wave. The signal frequency can be 500 Hz, 1 kHz, 2 kHz, 3 kHz. The pulse amplitude modulation can have either natural sampling, flat top sampling, or sample and hold. Output of this PAM is fed to the input of pulse amplitude demodulator, which is basically consists of frequency demodulator, diode detector, and a low pass filter. Output of this demodulator is obtained at this point. So we can observe the message signal, modulated wave and demodulated wave on the oscilloscope. This is our original message signal. This is our PAM modulated wave. And in order to observe the output, we connect CRO probe at the output of the demodulator, and with the help of waveforms, we can identify that output of the demodulator is a replica of original message signal. In this way, we have performed pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation in this video. Thank you very much.